director of the National Institute for Curriculum Development in Netherlands.
Right.
So my question is simple. What is, in your opinion, the critical issues regarding the positioning of the curriculum in the post-2015 area?
Okay. I think curriculum thinking is crucial if you talk about quality of education, because quality of education is not something that you just grab out of the air. Yeah? What we have seen in the education agenda so far was quite an emphasis, you might say, on the quantity of education. How can we get more children into the education system, access? Now there's the shift towards more quality. And I think curriculum thinking is very important if you try to grasp what quality of education actually means. Because everybody likes quality, nobody is against quality of education. But what do we talk about? And it's good from a curriculum perspective to distinguish between various components of quality, if you might say, different aspects. And the first one always is, I would say, is relevance of learning. The curriculum is basically a plan for learning, but what are they actually going to learn, and for what reason, for which overall purpose, from which rationale or mission or vision? That is key for curriculum thinking. In curriculum thinking, you try to develop arguments, storyline about for what reason are the children actually going to learn? Is it to prepare them for the labor market? Is it to prepare them to become a proper citizen? Is it to prepare them for continuing studies? Is it to equip them for further personal development? Probably all of the above. So you're always looking for a combination of different overall aims of education. And it's typical curriculum thinking to try to see the whole picture, so a holistic idea, and how you can combine it, and how you can strike a proper balance between preparing for further studies, continuous education, lifelong learning, labor market, citizenship, individual development. If you have this overall idea of what students are learning for, of course, then it's a bit more of a tactical matter how you're going to organize that, in which kind of subjects or themes or grades, and what are the resources, and how can we assess it, and how we can prepare teachers. But it's, I would say, debates and policies about the quality of education should start and end with a curriculum conversation. What are they actually learning, and for what reasons, and what deserves most priority? Because there are always thousands of wish lists, what students should learn, and you have to set priorities. But then you need clear lines of thinking where it all comes together. And the curriculum that should provide the glue for all those different claims on education.